Stan Emmert from Rainmakers TV. Bob asked me to fill in for him, and you know, you guys know Bob, so you don't say no to him. What we're trying to do here is to give Seattle City Council something to do. We see that they don't have enough to do, and what it is that there's an opportunity to honor someone who, as a baseball player, we've had a tremendous joy watching over the years, and his play career is over. But now might be just the time to change the name of the street. And the gentleman who is spearheading this effort is right here to talk to us just for a few minutes, time, Glenn Garnett.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm the project coordinator for the Ken Griffey Jr. Way project. Essentially, what we're trying to do is convince the City Council of the City of Seattle to regain one block of First Avenue into Ken Griffey Jr. Way that runs from Edgar Martinez Drive to Aurora Borough. Now, it requires a little bit more than just talking to the City Council. I've been talking to them for nearly since he retired, and they have said that we need to get the businesses involved. The businesses over at the Pyramid Ale House, there's about 12 businesses in all on the First Avenue block. They have to consent to have this change. This is where I need your help at. I asked Rebecca Hill over at the Seattle Mariners, and she referenced me off to you. I didn't know you existed until last month. And I'm glad I do now, because you're a great group of people. I've been reading a lot about you, your toys for a Tots Drive and everything else. You're a great group of people, and I look forward to working with each and every single one of you. So what I need you to do is, if you know people that work over at the Pyramid Ale House, inside the Pyramid Ale House, there's a second or a third floor, believe it or not. And you just need to convince them that this is where we need to be. We need to rename a street after Ken Griffey Jr. We need to have something that says, this is the house that Junior built, and here is his street that it's on. Easily identifiable by anybody, from outside the United States to as far away as Boston, Massachusetts. Everybody knows Griffey. And why Griffey? Well, when you really think about it, he's going to be easily in the Hall of Fame in 5 years. And there's no question in my mind, I will be there saying, yes, we can do this. We need your help. We need you to come along. Now, just renaming the street is not enough. What we have planned for the future with this project is to have a statue built in his likeness to be placed in front of Safeco Field, right at the home plate entrance. This will be made out of bronze. We're looking at artists right now. We're hoping to start fundraising for this in the near future so we can have this done. The total timeline for when we complete this project is by opening day 2011. Now, this is not going to be an easy task. A lot of businesses have already said, no, we won't change. The main concern was the letterhead. It will cost money to replace their letterhead, business cards, and other advertisements. Now, some of these businesses across the street, they pull in quite a bit of dollars, especially for the city of Seattle. And my thoughts are, and a lot of people are thinking, is if you attach Ken Griffey Jr.'s name to anything, it will make money. And I don't know where that is. Is that my cue, Lee? I'm being played on. Yeah, thank you so much. Have a great night. But we need to convince those businesses across the street. And the issue with the letterhead and the business cards, you're using it anyway. You're going to replenish your supply anyway. So this is the excuse you give them. You need to replace it. Once your supply is gone, reorder it with the new name. It won't cost you a dime. This project is expected not to cost any money except for the taxpayers, maybe a couple $1,000 just to replace a couple aluminum signs and to put them up. But if the City Council asks us to pay for this, we're looking at roughly about $2,000 to $3,000 to have this put in place. Not a lot of money when you have 4,000 people on Facebook alone. Each one can sit in a dollar. There's your money to put up a sign. Really doesn't cost that much money to replace business cards and letterhead once you already have an account. All it is just a few keystrokes and that's it. So what I need you to do is to help me out. We have a website, we have a Facebook, we have a Twitter. Tell as many people as possible. King Five's Evening Magazine just recently done a story on the Ken Griffey Jr. Way project. It's expected to air October 28th at 7 p.m. It's coming up a couple weeks. They will be talking about us in detail. Matter of fact, they filmed with me for about an hour and a half. Me talking to businesses, me talking to just people around. So, if you know people, send them to our website, www.KenGriffeyJrWay.com, or you can find us on Facebook. Just type in Ken Griffey Jr. Look for his rookie card, his upper deck rookie card. I imagine a lot of people have that card in this room. And also on Twitter, Ken Griffey Jr. Way. Thank you so much. And I look forward to hearing from you. If you need to email me, Glenn at Ken Griffey Jr. Way, I monitor it a lot. So thank you so much, and I look forward to talking to each one of you personally. Thank you.